Welcome, everybody. My name is Michael Lurk-Kubera. Today we are discussing about the election, the Georgia election. For all those not in America, you still might be surprised, but there are individual state-run elections which will decide, this particular one will decide who is running the Senate, whether it will be a gridlock, meaning regardless of who will be the president of the United States of America, the Republicans and the Democrats, I'm sure you're familiar, there's two parties. Well, if they're both in control and they're both tugging at one another's hamstrings, it's a huge tug of war. It's gridlock. You can't get anything passed in there. If either the Republicans win or the Democrats win the Georgia election, that means it's heading towards one way. Now, there will be gridlock regardless because it's not just the Senate that you have to look at. It's also the House of Representatives, the Cabinet, the President, everybody. Congress is obviously very important. And why am I making this video, a political video, I guess you could say? It's because it's cryptocurrency related. So over the past 4 years, I guess I can make a video on President Trump and his crypto policies and people that he hired. Some were pro-crypto, some were against crypto. I mean, that's going to happen in every single presidency. Not everybody can be on your side, and that's actually a good thing because it's diversified. Well, former Box CEO Kelly Loeffler lost her Georgia seat today. So it's not looking too good for the Republicans. It's not over till it's over on January 20th, but for Georgia, it is confirmed that she lost it. So Bakkt is headquartered actually in Georgia. You're probably familiar with it, but if you're not, it was created in 2018. It's owned by ICE, the Intercontinental Exchange Inc. And Bakkt is a digital marketplace that is allowed to store customers' bitcoins. Bakkt is designed to serve as a scalable on-ramp for institutional, merchant, and consumer participation in digital assets by promoting greater efficiency, security, and utility, said ex-Bakkt CEO Kelly Loeffler. So Bakkt is part of the institutional investors going into Bitcoin, going into cryptocurrency. It's on the New York Stock Exchange, so it's from Wall Street, and it owns over $1.2 trillion of digital assets, so that's a huge number right there. So Loeffler was running against Democratic nominee Raphael Warnock. She lost her seat this Tuesday, and she served for over a year. She left a crypto warehousing company late in December 2019 to fill former Senator Jeanne Isaacson's seat after Isaacson stepped down due to health concerns. So there was two Democratic nominees, and there was two Republican nominees. If one for Republicans and the other one for Democrats, it would be gridlock. If both Democrats or both Republicans won, you know where it's going to go. It determines the fate of the Senate. So Loeffler and Warnock were running for one seat, and Democratic John Ossoff and incumbent Senator David Perdue ran for Georgia's other Senate seat. Both Democrats winning would clear the way for President-elect Joe Biden to enact his agenda by creating a 50-50 split in the upper house. Now, I'm part of the camp that still believes Donald J. Trump is staying in power, but hey, we'll see. However, if both of the Republicans won, that would mean Majority Leader Senator Mitch McConnell would be able to stay in power. He'd enjoy another 2 years running the Senate. So Ossoff's Perdue race still has not been called yet, but Loeffler has, so she lost. Democrats have controlled the House of Representatives since 2018, and a week ago, some bets were taking place that Democrats would win for the Georgia seat. These were actually crypto bets. It was a crypto-powered prediction market. Polymarket had predicted that Warnock will win since December 31st, and Ossoff to win since earlier this month. We'll see about Ossoff. Loeffler ran Bakkt since its inception in mid-2018 through her appointment to Congress. However, the senator hasn't so much as mentioned Bitcoin or crypto since taking office. I'm sure she has her personal reasons for that, but she's still a supporter, obviously. She did have some controversy, though. So her husband, which is the ICE CEO Jeffrey Sprecher, they both sold between $1.3 million and $3.2 million in stock after they received a private Senate briefing. Ooh, yeah. So they're not the only ones who got in trouble in hot water. They also had the Pfizer CEO, and there was a bunch of CEOs actually with the vaccine, with COVID-19, with all these lockdowns. A bunch of them were dumping their stock. So that's just part of the elite. An ICE statement at the time claimed financial advisors to the two made those two transactions independently. Loeffler refused to concede, so it's still not over fully 100%, as conceding is a tradition, not a legal requirement. And she's also following Mr. Donald J. Trump. The president also refuses to concede, which, I mean, hey, if there's election fraud, if there's something fishy going on, we gotta get to the bottom of it. The price of Bitcoin, by the way, today is absolutely phenomenal. We hit over $35,000, and we actually hit over $36,000 currently. Currently, it's $34,780. That is still above where we were previously at $34,608. The total market cap of all cryptocurrencies is at $958 billion. Bitcoin's dominance has fallen to 67.7%. Ethereum is almost about to hit $1,200. We are very, very, very close to $1 trillion total market capitalization. On January 6th at 8:10 UTC time, we hit $972.3 billion. So less than $28 billion away from that $1 trillion, the magical number. We are very, very close. We're on our way up again. And 10 hours ago, Bitcoin hit its all-time high, new all-time high of $36,361.32, which means somewhere out there in this world at that time, someone was selling for an above market rate of 37, 38, 39, maybe even $40,000+. We're inching our way towards 40K, so we're probably gonna have some videos on that. But in the meantime, if you're new, hit that like button, subscribe, check out my secondary channel. The link will be in the description below, and we shall see you guys tomorrow.